大家好, I'm Nathan Rich, aka 火锅大王. You know, when you're going against the mainstream narrative in the West, there's often hell to pay. The right-wing mentality of colonialism and expansionism saturate some countries in the West. And if you dare make this suggestion, maybe you should stop trying to conquer the world. You get attacked by angry mobs so helplessly lost that they're nearly beyond rescue.They call out for democracy as they push against the people's will. They cry for the end of fascism in their own country while supporting fascist expansionism across the globe. The hypocrisy is rampant, and the causes are well known, or at least they should be by now. When I look at how people talk about Hong Kong's riots, I find the clearest examples of this insanity possible. There's not much wrong with the average Westerner when it comes to intent. They want to do what's right.They're good people. The issue I see is their ideas of what's right often conflict with their own principles. The confusion comes from the same place we all knew it would. It's the same issue we've been talking about for decades. The crooked, corrupt, and partisan media doing the devil's deeds. My life has always been different, I admit that. But these days it's been different in a, well,different way. I get the fun experience of going through thousands of emails, comments, and messages in which I encounter people who say things like this. This is real. Dear Nathan, I'm a Hong Konger, born and raised in Hong Kong. I have never been so afraid. Rioters dominate everything here. You can get beaten up if you dare to say something different than their message. They will take your phones and search you.Reporters ignore or cover up most of the violent acts. The police are being too soft on them and cannot protect the citizens. Those of us not joining the rioters are afraid to leave our homes or speak out on social media. I get many messages like these. This morning I got another one from a man asking me for help. He says he can't express his viewpoints even online. He's isolated. He doesn't know what to do. People send me video after video after video of rioter violence.They throw Molotov cocktails into police buildings. They swarm people, get them out of their cars, and beat them in the street. Bricks, firebombs, sticks, heat lasers, slingshots, on and on. These people are angry and violent. That much is obvious and proven without any doubt. Is it all protesters? Of course not. But the violence seems to be steadily growing. I've been saying this for months now. When did I start saying it? When the protesters started doing things that I knew would be met with more violence in Los Angeles than they would be in Hong Kong. Ironically, this is when the anti-police rhetoric started gaining traction. But to my annoyance, when I look at the reports of this situation, I find more or less the same exact narrative on the political left and right. And I'm going to show you how they do it. Now, I have a lot to say about why the American and British left often hates on China, and a different set of things to say about why the political right does. Interestingly, though, because they've been hating on China for so long, they're both trapped in their narratives. If you hate China so much, there's no other way to see these protesters than how they do. Peaceful, freedom-fighting hippies. I was doing some research today, and I watched a report by Vice on protests. Not Hong Kong protests.Ukraine protests from years ago. Very interesting. You see, I remember when Vice seemed relatively fair and balanced, or at least I thought they did. So I wanted to check my own sanity. How did they talk about riots in the Ukraine back in 2014? In their video called Ukraine Burning, a Vice journalist followed protesters around. He stood with them, talked to them, everything. The far-right protesters were anti-EU, violent and very active. They wanted freedom and democracy.They wanted independence. Sounds familiar. The government or the police were forceful. There were many, many deaths. Watching this 30-minute non-stop video by Vice is nothing short of shocking. But it's not the conflict that surprised me. No, it's the evidence of a change far more sinister. Interview after interview, protest after protest, violence, conversation, ideology, weapons, fear, anger. And yet from this video, I get no sense whatsoever.That these protesters are right, or wrong, or just, or unjust, or heroic, or stupid, or smart, or weak, or cowards, or strong. I get no sense whatsoever from Vice that I'm supposed to feel or think one way or the other. The views I form watching this video are shaped by two things, the footage being shown and my own interpretation. There is no overt attempt to shape what I should believe or feel. There's no sad or emotional music. And keep in mind, they dealt almost exclusively with only one side of the conflict, and I still don't get a biased picture. 30 minutes of pure political conflict, and after the viewing, I feel only that the event was interesting, and that if I wanted to know more, I should do further research. In other words, even as recent as 2014, it appeared that there was still relatively unbiased reporting happening at Vice. Fascinating. Now, let's look at one of Vice's reports on Hong Kong riots just 5 years later. This video is only 4 minutes long.
Police pepper sprayed a group of protesters who gathered to express solidarity with 62 protesters arrested for their alleged role in this weekend's demonstrations.
It begins by framing an event as police pepper sprayed protesters who were standing in solidarity with protesters who got arrested for their alleged role. Sad music is playing in the background. We learn that the protesters are pro-democracy, and they feel the police are violating their right to be heard.
The grievances of pro-democracy protesters, they see rioting charges that come with up to 10 years in prison as a way to criminalize their right to be heard.
Then we find out that there were clashes. Then we see this guy get pushed out of the way and this lady yelling at police. The police clearly announce the specific laws people are breaking and tell them to stop. They warn people not to attack them or they will have to advance. The sad music continues. We see there was an attack by some kind of gang wearing white, and police were slow to arrive. But the police were quick to arrive for the protests, it tells us. Then we see police arresting people. Protesters are backing up. Then protesters march against police violence, it says.
Protesters marched against police violence. They didn't stick to approved routes. Once again, confronted riot police, who used the same tactics that inspired the protest itself.
They didn't stick to approved routes, so technically they broke the law. Then the police came in. The police used the same tactics that inspired the protest itself, Vice tells us. Then we see people resisting arrest and B-roll footage, and it's over. When I see that video, here are the messages that I get from it. These poor, outnumbered, innocent protesters are just trying to establish democracy peacefully, but the oppressive police keep following them around and beating them and tear gassing them because they just hate them. Usually the police nail the protesters on some tiny technicality, like protesting on the wrong street corner, and then they give them harsh prison sentences. China mainland is scary and it's controlling the Hong Kong police. Somehow. If only Hong Kong had its own government with law and order, everything would be peaceful and good. This video clearly promotes the messages. China bad. Hong Kong not China. Hong Kong police violent. Protesters peaceful. Protesters fighting for democracy. Democracy good. Protesters good. All that in just 4 minutes, compared to a 30-minute video about the Ukraine, which had literally none of that. So let's take a closer look. Remember those protesters who were just randomly pepper sprayed? They make no mention at all that the clash was caused by the protesters throwing rocks and other objects at police officers. Here's a video of what happens in my home country, America, if you throw a rock at a police officer.
Put it down. What? You. Missed.
No! That would happen!
They try to tase her twice, then tackle and arrest her. Here's what she looked like after the arrest. But her black eye is the least of her worries. She was charged with 3 felonies with a total maximum sentence of $25,000 fine and 25 years in prison. There was no outcry about the charges or sad music during the news footage. And you notice how they said protesters' alleged role with the sad music in the background? They say alleged to emphasize the protesters are being accused of something. They might not have actually done it, but you see, having a role in something is not a crime because the ambiguity of the word role. That means they don't have to use the word alleged. They don't tend to use that word in the Ukraine video, for example, because it's obvious who's doing what. The idea here is to always land on the side of the protesters, always doubt claims against the protesters. They're always assumed to be in the right. The video simply calls the protesters pro-democracy. But of course, the protests started as an anti-government movement and later adopted a mixed bag of requests, including releasing criminals from jail, suffrage, and a symbolic unmaking of the rule of law. I won't go into the demands here, but if enough people request me to do so, I will make a separate video addressing what I think of them. In actual fact, many of these people are committing illegal acts of violence to achieve political ends. According to Hong Kong law, that is called terrorism. Now, no one really wants to call them terrorists because we all understand that it still could be worse. But even in a less inflammatory and more descriptive sense, the movement has at the very least factions of it that commit riots. These are not opinions, but legal, technical, objective facts. Yet all of that is just squished into pro-democracy by Vice. This is the face of deliberate misinformation. The police are violating their right to be heard. Are these the longest protests ever? I'm half joking, but think about it. We have heard about them. We have heard about them quite a lot. They're committing crimes literally every single day now, and there has been almost no action against them compared to previous Hong Kong protests. They're heard. Everyone hears them. No one is violating their right to be heard. Remember this guy intentionally blocking police who gets pushed out of the way? What he's doing results in immediate arrest in America. He would be trampled and arrested immediately. If only Hong Kong could be a democracy, then they would be able to protest in peace. If they were in the West, everyone would just leave them alone and let them protest. Thanks, everybody. See you soon.